Dr. Alexei Yablokov from the Russian Academy of Sciences, whose extensive collection of Chernobyl publications was recently published by the New York Academy of Sciences. Dr. Yablokov.
I am proud to be here and express my vision, my understanding of the Chernobyl situation. 24 years ago, it was Mikhail Gorbachev who asked me to chair the Committee of Ecology of Soviet Parliament. I was Soviet parliamentarian. I immediately understand that Chernobyl is the number one environmental catastrophe in Soviet Union. And later, Gorbachev accept that from Chernobyl, it was start to collapse of Soviet Union. After collapse of Soviet Union, I was advisor to the Russian president. That time it was Boris Yeltsin, who also support my, not investigation, my not study, but my activity to dig the truth about Chernobyl. Possible to explain all detail. I tried it main problem. What such evolution of official point of view? Immediately after Chernobyl, in several months, in several days, all officials, international and national Soviet Union, predict no immediate dangers, just absolutely the same like in Fukushima. No immediate dangers. It's like slogan. No elevating of cancer risk. Later, in several years, they accept that total death toll will be about 9,000 and number of sick about 200,000 for Chernobyl generation up to from 1986 to 2056. Now, UN scare discuss not established, but discuss incident of thyroid cancer, leukemia, solid cancer as whole, cardiovascular mortality, cataract, and autoimmune system. It happened under our pressure when we published a lot of paper. All Chernobyl literature, scientific literature, I think about 30, maybe 35,000 published papers. It's impossible to review all of this paper in detail. I know about 5,000, maybe 6,000 of this paper. All this prediction based on invalid concept of average effective dose. What is my understanding now? It was dose conception. When we calculate any dose, it's a trick which profitable only for nuclear industry. How possible real estimate the dose during first day and week, when the level of radiation after any nuclear catastrophe 1,000, maybe million times higher than it happened in 1 month, in 2 months? It's impossible. How is possible to estimate consequences of hot particles? How it possible to patchy contamination? Any contamination, radioactive contamination is patchy, spotted. It's impossible to calculate it exactly. How it possible to calculate dose from all radionuclide, not only from cesium, not only from strontium, but from many. Look for this picture. This is during the first day, first month, combination of radionuclide. It was about 60 or 70 different radionuclide. It was not cesium, it was not strontium, who was cause the high level of radiation during first day. Later, they change this combination, and so on, so on. How it possible to estimate influence of each radionuclide by dose conception? Impossible. Simple impossible. Look for this. This is a Greek. Especially not for Russia, because for Russia, for Ukraine, for Belarus, we have hundreds of such pictures, but it's Greek. Greek, and this is argentum. Look, not cesium, not strontium. Argentum, argentum.
Silver.
Yeah.
Silver.
Huh?
Silver.
Silver, silver, sorry. Argentum is the Latin name. Yeah, and this is cesium. So look, patch, at patchiness from silver, differ from patchiness from cesium. How it possible to correctly apply the average Weising coefficient for calculation of dose? All dose is not real data. It's calculation. It's calculation by some presumption. One of the presumption, we have average Weiss coefficient for skin, one coefficient for brain, other coefficient for lung, third coefficient. So it's absolutely unrealistic. It average. It look like average temperature for hospital. Next big discrepancy for dose. It's average consumption. Average consumption for air. Average consumption for water. Average consumption for food. It's impossible. It's impossible. All dose calculation for Belarusian people based on real calculation for 1.1% people. It's absolutely non-representative. Maybe I remind that all data for DOS based on the uniform phantom is means healthy white man, age 20 years. How many healthy white men among us, among people who suffering from radiation? Is zero, near to zero. Also, in Chernobyl, in Fukushima now, we have a lot of falsification. In Soviet Union, it was official secrecy up to 3.5 years after catastrophe. If we have special, we know document, one of this document here, when Ministry of Public Health have special order to change the medical data. Never put in the record the truth about Chernobyl, about radiation consequences. How is it possible based on this data? Impossible. Main postulate of average effective dose concept contradicts a large volume of data. The individual effective equivalent dose is the main criteria for World Health Organization and other organization could not be efficient for estimation of real level of irradiation of people. But what we what we can do? How obtain real information? We have data. We have such way. Morbidity of population, having identical background, physical, environmental, and so, and difficult, and differ only in radioactive contaminated on its territory. And health of the same group of individuals, which study in different time after catastrophe, in 1 year, in 10 years, in 20 years, the same group of people. The health of the same individual in regard to disorders which connected, strongly connected only with irradiation, like stable chromosome aberration. So we have scientific approach to collect data. We have it. Nuclear scientists reject this approach, but I used it. It published. First of all, this book, Chernobyl Consequences, first time was published in St. Petersburg in year 2007. After this, it was published in New York Academy of Science, And after this is published in Kyiv two years ago, and now in maybe in one month it will be published in Tokyo, in large edition. So I think it's the most up-to-date independent review of Chernobyl consequences. It's reflect, I think, about 5,000 papers, maybe 6,000 papers, but it's give us the true picture. Several examples. This is solid cancer incidents in the province which heavy contaminated at the upper curve. This is This is heavy contaminated province, Russian province, Bryansk province. This is less contaminated, and this is average for Russia. Visible. No other reason for such differences in cancer rate. Only Chernobyl consequences. We don't know what exact radionuclide affect Bryansk province, but we have result. We have result. This is cancer dynamic of thyroid cancer morbidity after Chernobyl in Belarus and Ukraine. You can see all when we compare. When we compare less contaminated and more contaminated area, immediately we have effect. Nobody explained this outside of Chernobyl. Only Chernobyl, nothing more. No reason for such a differences between populations. This is dynamic of thyroid cancer in Greece and Romania. The same. I also take this country outside of Soviet Union because we have a lot of data for Soviet Union, many. But even here we have papillary form of cancer much jumped after Chernobyl. No other explanation, only Chernobyl. Breast cancer, the same situation. The area with low level contamination have low level of cancer, and area with high level of contamination have a rising in 10 years after Chernobyl, jumped exactly is in the textbook. In 10 years after Chernobyl, this cancer have to arise. It will happen in Fukushima also, absolutely, I am sure. This is example of awful picture. We have several, I don't know, not exact data, but it's typical malformation. Professor Vertilevsky will be discussing it in detail, I hope, but we have such a huge, maybe several hundred every year additional such people. This is lens opacity. It's not cataract. Cataract accept, even nuclear scientists accept it. Cataract, yes, one of the reasons for irradiation. It's lens opacity. Look, what has happened. Strong correlation between body burden, how many becquerel in body, and how many lens opacity in eye in children. This is prevalence of trisomia, Down syndrome. Great similarity between West Berlin, Berlin is here, and this is Belarusia. It's interesting approach, Sperling and Professor Sperling. Look, after Chernobyl, the level of these illnesses slightly differ from previous. They called it broken stick model. It's interesting for many illnesses, the same situation. This is such a combination, all data. What we have, what disorder we have with Chernobyl? Practically all system: blood, endocrine, immune, urogenital tract, skeletal system, so on. Every system have some visible consequences after low level irradiation, which continue many years. Among consequences of Chernobyl, premature aging, even children became similar with some elder people. So it's aging, mutation, of course, change of sex ratio. Some German statistic calculates that about 1 million girl, less one million girl after Chernobyl consequences on the global globe. Officials and nuclearists usually insist that it's psychological factor, radiation phobia. Yesterday, Professor Musso very visibly explained what is a psychological factor for barn swallow and some other animals. Continue. What radiation phobia for frogs, for pine tree, which we have this similar broken chromosome and so on. This is several examples. Very difficult to calculate miscarriage. The level of many journalists ask me what the consequences in Chernobyl in the death. How it calculate? Very difficult. First of all, miscarriage. A lot of miscarriage. Maybe 100,000 miscarriage all over the globe was after Chernobyl. The same situation in Fukushima. I am sure. Look for this, it's deviant for infant mortality. It's just statistical data, it's nothing more. What we can see the jump after Chernobyl catastrophe, some jumped in infant mortality. This is Germany and this is Poland, but we have the same data for any country. I ask Alfred Korblein, it's a wonderful statistician from Germany, from München, collect data for me. He immediately he take the statistical, official statistical data. Look for this. This is Switzerland. After Chernobyl, unexplained level of rising of child mortality. The same in Finland. The same for any European country. The same. No explanation, only Chernobyl. Look for this latest data for Fukushima. I know that Jan Farley will be, after me, will be detailed discuss the situation. I just show this. After the same, like in, after Chernobyl, we have here jumped, unusual, statistically detectable, jumped in infant mortality for all Japanese population, not for vicinity of Fukushima, but for all. If we study vicinity of Fukushima, it will be more visible absolutely. Some St. Petersburg statistician try to collect data about mortality in heavy contaminated area, heavy contaminated after Chernobyl. This is heavy contaminated, 6 Russian province, and less contaminated, situated near to heavy contaminated. Differences, you see, statistically, very strong differences. The data after 15 years, it looked like 4% additional death rate, 4%. This similar data I catch from Ukraine and from Belarus, 4% and 3% and 7%, something about 4%. For first 15 years after Chernobyl, the total mortality decreased in heavy contaminated area, like in Fukushima, for 4%. It means if we calculate it more and more for all of Chernobyl fallout, by the way, bulk of Chernobyl fallout go away from Soviet Union. Soviet Union received only about 40% of Chernobyl radionuclide. 60% received Europe, Africa, Asia, even United States. So if you calculate step by step, it looks like about Chernobyl death toll for 15 years, about 800,000. Many nuclear scientists blame me for this data. I ask them, please show me where my calculation is wrong. No one never show me some mistake in my calculation. The same. If all animals, plant and microorganism have the height level of change in contaminated area, it's impossible to say about phobia and psychological factor and something else. Same. The main Chernobyl lesson: the nuclear industry. There is the same risk to our planet with nuclear power, not only theoretically, but practically, in the same level risk for humanity and the Earth at whole as a nuclear weapon. Thank you very much.
Спасибо большое. Really nice to hear things that we don't often hear because of language or geography. I think it was very important also to come back to a message that came from yesterday as well, which Dr. Yablokov alluded to, which is that the results depend on the assumptions. And if the assumptions do not include all of the known data, you will get erroneous results.